Once this window closes, any late registration will attract a penalty.
Addressing journalists today, the acting NSSF managing director, Patrick Ayota, noted that at least 50,000 employers have failed to remit their workers' contributions to the National Social Security Fund, and if they fail to do so in the next 30 days, they will face action from the fund. Ayota explained that since the law came into force, only 3,200 employers have registered to start contributing to the fund for their employees. He noted that they are looking at 50,000 employers and 1.2 million employees in the next 5 years.
We are targeting both employers and entities for this mandatory drive. In terms of campaign execution, we have provided multiple options for new members and employers to conveniently register with the fund and start contributions. For example, employers may use our online self-service channels via the NSSF Go mobile app and web app. Individual members are required to have their NIN and registered phone number. Employers are required to have their URA tax identification number.
According to the acting NSSF managing director, employers who have not yet remitted their employees' contributions have 30 days to fulfill this legal requirement or face stern actions.
We call upon unregistered employers across the country to take advantage of the next 30 days to regularize their status with the fund. And in the process, they will avoid a penalty that would be associated with the registering late. Once this window closes, any late registration will attract a penalty.
Uganda Law Society Executive Officer Moses Okwalinga has urged employers to register their employees to avoid onboarding avoidable financial penalties.
In practice, the penalty for non-compliance with NSSF is very burdensome because it's compounded every month on an entity that does not pay. In particular, I urge my colleagues in the legal fraternity, the law firms, all advocates. The law now requires everyone. The threshold has been lowered, so please comply.
The executive director for the Federation of Small and Medium Enterprises, John Walugembe, urged all members to take advantage of the 30-day window to register for NSSF contributions.
For the MSMEs out there, we'd like to say that the NSSF Act was amended, and Section 7 and 13A requires all businesses, irrespective of size, to contribute to NSSF for their employees. Therefore, we want to urge you to be compliant. For NSSF, we want to ask you to intensify the education. Let's educate our MSMEs. As MSMEs do not appreciate the value of Social Security. Every small money matters to them. So they need to appreciate why it's important.
Section 1, Clause D of the NSSF Act defines an employer to include the government, a company registered or incorporated under the Companies Act 2012, a partnership registered under the Partnership Act, and a trustee. It also includes a business registered under the law. Section 7 and 13A of the amended NSSF Act introduced mandatory contributions by all workers, regardless of the size of the enterprise or the number of employees. Report compiled by Sharon Navasirie for the news.